don't think is the correct thing. We can refurbish the pier, which I think should have a hard look at. Of those 23 things that came in, there was a lot of look at how it could be done. You know, the original thing about rebuilding the pier said let's make it 125 foot wide entrance. That's probably difficult and expensive, so there may be another way to do that, so that needs to be looked at. And the new thing is that we need to also try to get the input from the community so we can try to figure out what would be the next step if we don't do 1, 2, or 3. And I'm glad to be on the mayor's task force. There's an awful lot of Windsors on that task force, Wowzers and others, but you know, something I learned early on is if everybody's playing ball, you can't take your ball and go home and play by yourself. So I'm there to do that. So we would like to entertain some questions or answers or suggestions from people on how we might get this done. Bill, if you'll come up, we'll answer a few questions, and let you all speak. And we need your input. I mean, don't, whatever it is, if you're feeling it, let us know, because we need to know what people feel, because our job as concerned citizens is try to help the citizens do what they want. So
Fred,
give us your input.
People make a financial contribution to help the program.
Yeah, it has been expensive, and if you'd like to make a financial contribution, we'd appreciate it. We have, we'll take a check tonight. In fact, I think we have our treasurer here. Where's he? There he is right there. He'll take a check tonight, and he'll report you as being a good supporter. We also have, if you go on our website, you can actually put a credit card in there. If you want to give us $10 or $50 or $500 or $10,000 or $20,000. All those raise your hand for $20,000. Okay.
Yeah,
anyway.
Except to use Mercedes 1999 or later model.
Yeah, well, we'll take cars, resell them, whatever. You know, Bill can handle that. Yes, ma'am.
Could you explain how are you going to explain to the voters about yes, you're voting no, you're, I mean, I see the visual, but I still hear people confused about which way they're going to vote when they go in and look at the ballot. Can you talk about that?
Yes, I think that's an excellent point. I've been voting more. Yeah, the question is, how do you explain the fact that you have to vote yes to cancel the lens? And we, by the way, have some handouts, and we appreciate you taking them with you to look at. The way that the government, the council, the cities, they kind of make these ordinances very difficult to do, because they would like to do the governing, and they would like for you to not be involved other than voting for them. But every once in a while, you know, something comes up that is something that you disagree with the people you elected. And I think this is one of those situations, because we found that between 65 to 70% of the people don't like the lens. They don't think it's St. Petersburg. It's just as simple as that. I mean, Bill said, thank you very much.
To answer your question, you will put that on the back of your car when you go out to it. Put it on the first car you see when you go out the door. But if we have these all over town, if we have these slashed or placed squarely on signs, depending on which school of advertising you adhere to, but if you have these out, just as our signs gradually got our message and showed our presence for the petition campaign, this is going to get people saying yes. Vote yes to stop the lens. It's that simple. So please take one of these. Do not shove it under your front seat. Put it on your car. They go on very easily and quickly.
Thank you, Bill. You know, the other thing is, I agree with Lorraine and Bill and myself. If you have a sign, put that thing crossways so that it's real obvious that it's a new situation.
It's a new message.
New message that vote yes. So the answer to your question is they make it difficult, they do it on purpose. We've got to overcome that. We've spent 10 months overcoming that, and we will overcome this going forward. We need to just get out and vote the people that understand this. Because there's a lot of people that don't understand. And people go to me and they say like, well, I thought they'd have the same thing on the new pier they had on the old pier. I mean, I could ask some people here, you know, the old pier has currently got 70,000 square feet of air conditioned space. The Lens has zero.
450.
Oh, sorry.
450.
Well, you know what the thing about it is, I like ice cream and he likes gelato. So let's have another question.
One question, I've talked to my neighbors and they've asked, is there a summary of like the key issues with the Lens? Is there any place to go to?
Yeah, our website has got some key issues. I will tell you one thing that we're going to start pushing more and more. Howard and Joe have put out a short presentation of this that explains what the problems are. And I think we need to get this media out. And where is Lorraine? Lorraine is pushing this out. And we'd like for you to send this, we're going to send out a 10-minute presentation of what you just saw to everyone we can find. And you need to send it out. And that's basically the way today people can try to understand what's going on. So we will send this out to you. It will tell you that it doesn't have any air conditioned space. It doesn't have it. It's a video. It's a YouTube. All you got to do is click on it. Doesn't matter what kind of computer you've got. It will work. So thank you for that, and we will get it out. Yes, sir.
The elderly gentleman in the dark.
You should talk. Fred, how are you going to communicate between now and the 27th? Your opposition is clear to the Lens. It's bad design. Yeah. You've got 23 resumes, and I heard nothing about new designs. But how are you going to convey to people that there is an option, an afterlife, that's even better, much better than what's been proposed, and you are in favor of using that property and that location as a family entertainment destination? In other words, you've had opposition, but you've got a dual message. Current design is not satisfactory, but there are options that would be satisfactory. How are you going to convey that message between now and the election?
You know, Jim, I appreciate that, and you know, it's good questions like that help us design what we're doing. You know, Dan early on said, you know, one thing we need to do is we need to help people understand that this is our waterfront, and we need to make sure that people understand what is being done. I think people do not understand what's being done with the Lens. So that's the first step. We've got to get that done. We've got to get rid of that. And that is the first step. The next thing we've got to do is we've got to try to put together a process. The original process did not include an RFP. It required an RFQ. And that is what is your qualifications? Would you build a house by somebody that said, I'm a good architect, you'd say, fine, build me a house. I don't care if it's air conditioned. I don't care if it's got a bathroom. I don't care if it's got three bedrooms or four or two or five. That's really where we went wrong. We should have had an RFP, which is something where they would submit to us ideas, and that's in regard to rebuilding the pier or building a new pier. We need to have an RFP, and that is what the new task force is supposed to do, come up with an RFP. And I think somehow we've got to get that message out, and you're correct. We'd be glad to get your input on that if you can help us. Questions?
Well, I think, Fred, there's also that we're doing robocalls and we're getting out publications and answers. You know, Jim, they're doing that. They're getting the message out between now and the next
couple
of weeks.
The first step is true. We will spend some money to make sure that our people get out and vote. Yes, sir.
And you really don't have to August the 27th. You said 50% of the ballots are basically going out very soon.
Next week.
And so the urgency is there. You need to do this as soon as possible to get these.
Right. It's kind of, you know, this is, by the way, we got a lot of supporters. Now that you're one of them, we know that. It's ours to lose. We just got to make sure that we got to email our people, and we will get Howard's video out very shortly. We'll get a good statement out. We've already, you know, if you'll pick up a copy of that flyer that shows you, you know, vote yes. So I think we got to get the vote yes thing. We got to get the video out. We got to get a little, Bill will probably write us a little commentary that we'll get out. And we need you all to just get that out to every single person you know and say, listen, we worked hard to get here. Now we got to get a vote. And Elliot, I appreciate that.
Do you have emails of everybody that signed the petition? Or, in other words, is there a way to get the ballot?
I wish you hadn't asked that. We really didn't get that done. We've got the petitions done according to the regulations, yeah. And probably we should have done better with that, but we do have a lot. Lorraine, would you like to say a few comments?
I'm going to answer her question. I believe we're doing a mailing next week. We're working on a mailing to go out next week to people who signed for both sides of the petitions. Vote on the appeal. So in answer to your question, we're on it, okay? That's being done right now, and it should be going out next week. Mail this to everyone who signed, I believe, both different petitions, which will encourage them to vote. Sorry.
Oh, that's good. Thank you.
Yeah, Fred just hit on his last remarks. We asked you to come here tonight, and we really wanted to celebrate what had been achieved. We can smell victory, but it is ours to lose. But you people, with your networks of friends, the people that you encounter, the hairdressers, the people that you know who carry the buzz, take time to talk to those people who talk to other people. I mean, taking the numbers in this room and the what that can expand out to can make the difference, but you just can't be quiet about this. You have to talk it up or we can lose this thing.
Yes,
Patty.
Do you have a list of the results of the turnouts and citywide election?
We have all those details extremely, okay? We know how many people are going to vote. We know how they're going to vote. We know what's going to happen. The thing that we can make a difference
is...
You're
having for breakfast tomorrow.
You know where. Bill reported to me.
I'm an Obama man. We have resources.
Bill just increased my taxes last week. So the answer to your question is we have all those details. He will send out those stuff. But I will tell you, you all, if everybody sent out 20 emails, 10, 5 emails to people, we're going to send something to you all because we have most of you all. And by the way, Lorraine, we had a sign up tonight for everybody.
It's in the front there.
Would you please give us your email? Any way you can give us your email, we're supposed to have a sign up for emails, and let's do that.
Will there be a commercial television commercial run? Is it in the budget? Will it
happen? We haven't gotten there yet. Mr. Risser's in a medical situation right now. He'll be back soon, and it's amazing what he does. Yes.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
Hey, Howard.
The last city council I went to, they brought in a whole row full of Boy Scouts. And they handed out blue t-shirts to these Boy Scouts. And Wingate got a little aggravated about that. And this kid sitting next to me said, what is this all about? And for me, being the forever teacher, I said, you know, honey, you need to listen to both sides of what's going on here, and you figure it out. After your presentation, this is how visual these kids are. He looks at me and says, I got the wrong t-shirt. And then he's stuffing it in his
pocket. I thank you for that. I thank you very much for that.
He's stuffing it in his pocket, and he says, I need a red t-shirt. How do I get it? I said, see that lady up here? And then I leaned over to Bill. So So I gave it to this kid and said, this is the best I could do for right now, but we'll get you a red t-shirt. That was a powerful piece you did.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. You know, my mother told me, she grew up in this community too, by the way, and she's not with us anymore today, but she said, the only thing you can do is make this a better place. That's it. You come to this world, you make it a better place. We're trying to make it a better place. I am so proud of our waterfront. We have one of the finest waterfronts there is in the country. I spend my time on it. I got my kids on it. I love it, okay? And I think we need to just keep it that way and not waste money that should be done. And I appreciate your comments. Those are very good comments. Yes, sir, David.
How's your coordination doing with the Tampa Bay Times?
The Tampa Bay Times.
They love it.
I'm gonna hold the lawyer back at this point. The Tampa Bay Times editorial board supports the Lens. They thought the process had been good. They did not do the work that I thought they used to do, where they did the hard work to find out, you know, what is underlying this? Did it go wrong? Was there a disconnect? And the disconnect was they didn't ask for an RFP, they asked for an RFQ. That's the disconnect. They didn't ask people to submit 20 designs, and then let's try to pick 10 of those. Let's boil down to 5 of those, and let's either redo the pier by this design, or let's put in something new by this design. And Dan will tell you also. Dan, by the way, is one of our board members, and he's a little bit controversial from time to time. But Dan gets in there and works hard, and you know there was a change in what could be done. We can actually address the uplands. And a lot of the uplands, and Dan will tell you that, he told me that at the last 828 meeting, that you can address the uplands, which I already knew because Dan told me about 10 times before that. He already told me, but he reminded everybody in the 828. So, you know, we could refurbish the pier with a different thing, and we could put a lot of stuff on the uplands with $50 million. Or we could refurbish the pier and put it all out there. Or we could pull it all back, or we could add something new out there. We need to find out what the community wants to do. We need to have a family-oriented destination that we're going to be proud of in St. Petersburg. Yes, sir.
Correct. What's given you got numbers on the expected turnout for the vote, what roughly is the number that we would need to get an affirmative action?
If the people that sign our petition comes out, we would swamp it. That'd be a 90%. Okay. And a lot of people here did sign one of those two petitions or both of them. Actually, only about 3,000 people signed them both. That was pretty interesting. But I don't want to give anybody any false hope, because what happens is, you know, somebody walks up to you and says, would you sign this petition? What's it about? What's it about the pier? Why is it? Whatever. You sign it, you go, but, you know, I got my family and I got something going on and I'm doing this and I don't go and I don't vote, you know. So we need about 25,000 votes. That's what we really need. We obviously had about 40,000 people sign petitions. So the real answer is if the petitioners came out, if all of us that signed the petition came out, we would knock it dead. I think we will win, but we need to make sure that we keep pushing all of our friends and all of our people.
I just have one follow-up. I'm not a marketing guy at all.
You know? Yeah, right.
Yeah. Well, you do know me, but I'm really not.
I'm moving on wallet.
Yeah, but I think we're in danger if we try to get into too much detail trying to convince people.
Yeah.
I think the message really needs to be clear. The three things that I've heard tonight are, you know, the way that I would articulate, do you like it, would you use it, and does it fit in with the city? And people will give, unless you say yes to all three, you shouldn't vote, you shouldn't vote yes, right?
That's correct.
If you agree with all those, you like it, you use it, you think it fits in the city, you're going to vote no on this thing.
Yeah.
I think the message needs to be really kind of boiled down to a couple of things, whether those are the things or not the things, but I think trying to get
too much into stuff.
Yeah, we're not.
25-foot wide, 24-foot wide. Let me tell you, this guy right now has changed the lens.
We agree. We're concentrating on vote yes stuff.
Yeah, we need to vote yes. And the reason you vote yes is because it doesn't fit the character. It doesn't have any air conditioning, might be a biggie. Okay. It doesn't have any restaurants or 36,000 square feet. That's it.
One of our petition gatherers gathered 300 petitions in a very short period of time, and I asked him, what are these people saying to you? It's ugly and it ain't worth 50 million.
That's two things.
You only need two. Yeah, you need to get it done in two.
Is this worth it?
All right, we're going to have a last comment here, and then we'll be here for questions. Rain, will you talk to us about the Facebook thing? Because I've been trying to learn how to do this, and you know how to do it.
No, just that we have Stockland's Facebook page, and I know many of you aren't, but many of you are or are thinking of going on Facebook. And I do run that page, and I mean, every single day I'm posting information. What we're doing, how we're doing it, where we're going. So if you want to stay tuned, that's including Saturdays and Sundays. Yes, I am a maniac. So please, if you haven't, if you are on Facebook and you haven't liked our Facebook page, please go there, especially marketing people, and we'll give you up-to-date information every day till the 27th when we win.
Translate up and stop.
Let me just say, we've got a couple of politicians here who spent their time. I'd like, if any of them would like to just have a short comment. We're glad for Steve and Kathleen, if they'd like to say anything. Carl, if you'd like to come forward.
Thanks, Fred. First, I'd like to thank everybody here who has been involved in this. It was an incredible job. I don't know that everybody really appreciates how really hard it was. Congratulations. I want to tell you out there on the campaign trail, people do not like the lens. But it's a palpable anger is what I call it. And you can just tell people are uncomfortable. The challenge is sometimes there will be one or two people who are for the lens. So the folks who are really disturbed and want to stop the lens kind of hunker down. And they are very passionate about the subject. So all we have to do is keep telling our friends it's really important. Get out there and vote. Because it is our waterfront, and that vote does matter. And I think you guys are doing a great job. Keep it up. I think, you know, August 27th is going to be here. And fingers crossed, voters marking yes on the ballot to stop the Maltan contract will get us there. Thanks.
I'm sorry.
The Maltan contract, yes or no?
There's a flyer out front. Take it with you. Thank you, Councilor Steve.
Hi, I'm Steve Gallagher. I'm running for City Council for District 8. I've been opposed to the lens since the beginning, and I got to tell you, from going out there and knocking on doors, I've knocked on close to 500 doors personally, and I don't think I've come up with a half a dozen people who like the lens. So. Everybody's is aware of what's going on. It's always the number one question when I tell them I'm running for city council. And I gotta tell you, most people do not want the lens. That's from door to door canvassing. So appreciate all you do.